subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 27th of September. Indian farmers stage nationwide protest to mark 1 year of farm loss. Activists hold protest demand Islamabad to dismantle terror camps in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. And residents in Afghan capital hope Taliban punishments deter crime, worry about implementation. And now for all the details. Indian farmers on Monday blocked highways and railway tracks as part of a nationwide strike to mark 1 year of introduction of three farm laws that they say will hurt their livelihood. The legislation introduced last September aims to liberalize the agriculture sector. Several rounds of talks have been held between farmer leaders and the central government, but the impasse remains.
Indian farmers opposed to three farm laws brought by Prime Minister Narendra Modi-led government blocked highways and railway tracks as part of a nationwide strike on Monday to mark 1 year since the legislation that aims to liberalize the agriculture sector was introduced. For the past 10 months, thousands of farmers have camped out on major highways around national capital New Delhi to oppose the laws, which they say will hurt their livelihood and leave them with scant bargaining power against big private retailers. The government says the measures allow farmers to directly sell their produce to big buyers outside government-regulated wholesale markets and will help them get better prices. Farmer leaders and the center government have held several rounds of talks, but the impasse remains.
ये तीन कानूनों को खत्म कराने के लिए हमारा देशव्यापी प्रोग्राम है और सारे देश में बड़ी सफलतापूर्वक से चल रहा है.
Meanwhile, workers of several opposition and left-aligned parties also staged demonstrations in southern Chennai and central Ranchi city in solidarity with the protesting farmers and urged people to come out in support of their cause. In southern Kerala state, shops, offices and all banks remained shut as the ruling Left Democratic Front government ordered a shutdown to show support to the demands of farmers. Farming sustains about half of India's more than 1.3 billion people and accounts for about 15% of the $2.7 trillion economy.
Every Indian will now get a digital health ID, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi said on Monday as he launched the Ayushman Bharat digital mission. Under this, a unique digital health ID will be provided to the people, which will contain all the health records of the person. According to the government, citizens will now only be a click away from accessing healthcare facilities.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday launched the Ayushman Bharat digital mission via video conferencing, saying this will bring revolutionary changes in the country's healthcare facilities. Ayushman Bharat digital mission includes a health identity card for every citizen that will also work as an account of personal health records that can be linked with the help of a mobile. A healthcare professional's registry and healthcare facilities registries that will act as a repository of all healthcare providers. The newly launched mission will benefit the poor and middle class in eliminating problems they face in getting medical treatment, PM said.
बीते सात वर्षों में देश की स्वास्थ्य सुविधाओं को मजबूत करने का जो अभियान चल रहा है वो आज से एक नए चरण में प्रवेश कर रहा है और ये सामान्य चरण नहीं है, ये असामान्य चरण है. आज एक ऐसे मिशन की शुरुआत हो रही है जिसमें भारत की स्वास्थ्य सुविधाओं में क्रांतिकारी परिवर्तन लाने की बहुत बड़ी ताकत है.
This initiative has enabled India to administer nearly 900 million COVID-19 vaccine doses thus far, Prime Minister Modi said, adding that even advanced countries do not have technology such as this. During the virtual event, he also talked about the Arogya Setu application and said it helped a lot in preventing the spread of COVID-19 infection. The pilot project of the Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission, also called the National Digital Health Mission or the PM Digital Health Mission, was announced by the Prime Minister during his Independence Day speech last year.
Moving on, political activists staged protests in Geneva and London this past weekend to demand Pakistan to dismantle terror camps and stop exploitation of natural resources in its occupied territories of Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan. They also highlighted human rights violations by the Pakistani establishment against ethnic minorities and demanded the international community to intervene.
Political activists from Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan held a protest outside the office of the UN Human Rights Council in Geneva over the past weekend to demand Pakistan to dismantle terror camps and stop the exploitation of natural resources and land grabbing in both the occupied territories. The protesters strongly condemned human rights violations by the Pakistani regime and its endeavors to silence all voices of dissent by introducing draconian laws to curb the basic civil rights. Political activist Shaukat Ali Kashmiri said that not only the Pakistan-administered Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan are victims of Pakistani atrocities, but the Baloch and Sindhis are also facing genocide at the hands of the Pakistani state and its security forces.
We are not frightened. We are fighting for our historical basic rights and rights of our nation to the self-determination. And we are with all suppressed nations. We are with an alliance of the Pakistan oppressed nation. And on the diaspora, we have an ally. We are one voice, and nobody can suppress our voice.
Meanwhile, scores of protesters also gathered in front of the residence of the Pakistani High Commissioner in London on Sunday to protest against Pakistan's Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi's official visit to the United Kingdom. The protesters demanded the British government not to entertain Qureshi and urged Pakistan must be held accountable for enforced disappearances and extrajudicial killings of political activists and denial of basic fundamental rights to people in its occupied territories.
In news from Pakistan, the opposition Jamaat-e-Islami party held a protest recently in Pakistan's Karachi city against skyrocketing inflation and unemployment in the country. Scores of protesters led by party's president criticized the government for failing to control the prices of essential commodities and also poor health facilities and water shortage in the city.
The opposition Jamaat-e-Islami party recently staged a massive protest in Pakistan's financial capital of Karachi against rising inflation and unemployment in the country. The protesters, including locals, slammed the Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government over its failure to control the frequent hike in prices of food and other essential commodities, which have hit domestic budgets of the people. They also raised concerns over poor health facilities and water shortage in Karachi city.
ये जो हुक्मरानों की बातें हैं ये बातों से तो हमारा पेट नहीं भरता गरीब का इन बातों से और उनके नारों से और उनके आदाद और शुमार से घर का खर्चा नहीं चलता आप बताएं कि गरीब आदमी कहां जाए अब मिडिल क्लास को भी इन्होंने फारिग कर दिया है मिडिल क्लास के लिए ना तालीम है बच्चों के लिए ना सेहत है ना वो जो है वो कोई भी सहूलत हासिल कर सकते हैं
Residents across Pakistan have expressed anger over skyrocketing food inflation and the recent hike in fuel prices by the government this month. The Pakistan government this month increased the prices of both petrol and diesel by rupees 5 per litre, taking the current price of petrol to rupees 123.30 and diesel to 120.04 rupees per litre.
In news from Afghanistan, under the Taliban rule, life is getting harder for Afghans as the new government is struggling to contain a deepening economic crisis. However, the number of crimes has been seen to be decreased and law and order in control. Kabul residents hope the Taliban punishments would help deter crime but are worried about the implementation of justice.
ever since the Islamist Taliban swept to victory in Afghanistan last month, after 2 decades of fighting, the number of crimes has been seen to be decreased. Kabul residents say they hope the Taliban punishments would help deter crime, but added they were worried about the implementation of justice.
فکر کوم دا د امنیت لپاره ډیره ګټه کوي چې دا غلو ونیسي او خبره دلته دا ده چې دوی باید دا په عام اصغر کې اعدام نه کړي او دا باید دوی ځان ته محکمه ورته جوړه کړي او د محکمې له لارې باید دوی هغه خپله سزا باندې ورسوي.
On Saturday in the western city of Herat, Taliban authorities killed 4 alleged kidnappers and hung their bodies up in public to deter others, a local government official said. According to Sher Ahmed Amar, deputy governor of Herat, the bodies had been hung in the main square as a lesson for other kidnappers. The 2 kidnapping victims were released unharmed. The Taliban have said they will continue to impose swift and severe punishments on lawbreakers to stop crimes like robbery, murder and kidnapping that have become widespread in Afghanistan, despite international condemnation. Though the Islamist groups say they do not intend to repeat the harsh fundamentalist rule of 1996 to 2001, they are struggling to convince the outside world that they have really changed. The economic crisis is among the biggest challenges facing the Taliban. They formed a male government of Taliban veterans and hardliners, and there are widespread reports of human rights abuses.
Moving on to news from Nepal. The Communist Party of Nepal Maoist Center, at its standing committee meeting held on Monday, made a decision to work toward giving a full shape to the cabinet at the earliest possible date. The party decided to resolve the legal complications halting the expansion of the cabinet by holding discussions with the coalition partners. The meeting also discussed the laws, ordinance and legal cases that are pending the final verdict in the Supreme Court to give a full shape to the cabinet. Earlier, Maoist Center Chair Pushpakamal Dahal expressed he was under immense pressure as all 49 lawmakers of his party aspires to become a minister. Even though Nepali Prime Minister Sher Bahadur Deuba has been asking for names of ministerial candidates for his coalition government, the Maoist Center, a key coalition partner, has not provided the list. It has been over 2 months since Deuba became the Prime Minister, and yet his government isn't in full shape. So far, Nepali Congress Party has 3 ministers and 1 state minister, and the Maoist Center has 2 ministers in the Deuba cabinet. Heavy rainfall continued in parts of India's Andhra Pradesh and Odisha states on Monday in the aftermath of Cyclone Gulab that made landfall along the eastern coast on Sunday night, leaving behind a trail of destruction. Disaster management personnel remained positioned in both the states as weather department warned that heavy rainfall could lead to floods.
Cyclone Gulab that made landfall along India's eastern coast on Sunday night left behind a trail of destruction on Monday as it damaged property, uprooted trees and destroyed electricity and communication networks in Andhra Pradesh and Odisha states. Heavy rains continued to lash several parts of both the states, while the weather department said the cyclonic storm was likely to weaken further into a depression. Local media reports said at least 3 people, including 2 fishermen, were killed in the cyclonic storm in Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. Residents in Srikakulam were seen checking on the damage, and some of them also resumed their daily life on Monday, while teams of police and National Disaster Response Force or NDRF remained positioned for rescue and relief operations, as meteorologists warned that heavy rainfall could lead to floods.
Intense to nahi hua, magar kya hai, road blockage wagera hua. Logon ka to kuch nahi hua hai, na logon ko evacuate kiya gaya hai. Abhi wo situation ban raha hai ki cyclone ke baad kya hai, turant baad ka situation banta hai. To usme agar evacuate karne ka, kisi ko MFR dene ka, rescue karne ka, humko waisa mauka aayega, to hamara team ready hai.
Authorities had evacuated people from low-lying areas and shifted them to relief centers on Sunday, while the entire coastal region was put on alert in view of the cyclone. Officials said the sea condition will be rough over the next 2 days, and fishermen have been warned not to venture into the sea.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.